Yeah, good morning to every one of us that are using the Edging Pro software. Today, I'm very sorry that I did this video a little bit late because this video is supposed to be in the group WhatsApp since Friday or Saturday before we started trading of the week. But I'm very busy with other things, but it's not too late. Yeah, what I just want to show, because like a good software needs to be need to come with a good support for the users. So since this software is my own personal thing, and now we are about 10 people using this software for the past 3 4 months, so I will be glad to tell all the users that the update will be coming from time to time. But the first thing is, this is the software. We have done the back testing for 11 years, for 7 years without losing the money. That is why we are doing forward testing of the software. And from the forward testing of the software, we can see this is my own personal account. So February we have negative 0.7%. Something happened here because the way this software was structured, we don't supposed to normally see losing months, but it's fine. So March we have 2.94, April I have 1.70, and the month of May we have 0.6%. All together, at the end of April, we're going to have about let's say 4 months. Then, but right now we have 5.24% profit. But I can bet you, I don't know the individual experience, but with my own experience, I realized that this year is a very low, I mean, very slow market year, that forex market does not move actually the way it really moves. It's just ranging between price in between price channel. So, but nevertheless, Edge Pro can take any condition. But like I said, please, every investment is risk, but there's a calculation risk you can take with your money, that from time to time, either the medium time or long time, you see have your capital, you see have profit, better than bad. Let's say we even close this month at 0.6%. This is better than anything a bank will give us on this kind of money in a month. But having said this, we have two other students, user, who permitted me to put their accounts on my social platform. So this person have made 1% of his account. Oh, sorry, I shut down the internet. Okay, we can see that this software user is 4 weeks that he started using the software. He put $500, which I advise that he should put in cent, which is 50,000 cents. And we can see how the software has been managing the account independently. So this is a live account as well, and this is another person. Which is Silver 2. It's another person's account, which is 5 weeks, and we can see how the software is managing the account. And this is the physical growth it has made in 1 month. Let's say in month of April, last week of the month of April, it did 0.12, and so far in May, we are on 0.51. And if we look at the drawdown. In let's come to risk, because drawdown is very important in forex trading. You can see that the drawdown, the maximum drawdown, we have absolute drawdown, we have maximum drawdown. The maximum drawdown on this account is 0.22%, which is still reasonable. If you risk 0.22 of this account, and to get get What do you get? You get almost 1%. Let me see here. I'm sorry. Okay, we risk 0.22% to get 0.64 return. So all this really matter in forex trading. Now, what is the purpose? The purpose of this video is to let all the users know that they have to adopt to another strategy so that we can get more profit. Since market refuse to move, we can do scalping with this software and have access to make more profit. So in this tutorial, I will launch to my server, because all the user knows what is server and why do we host our account on server. So I'm going to log into my server where my Metaphor platform is hosted. Then what am I going to do there is I'm going to reset the setting of my trading setting of the software. So that's what I actually to adjust. So this is a software in the server. So what we're going to do now is, first of all, I need to, because this one is still at loss and I don't want to lose all this trade. I don't want to lose this trade by closing it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the setting without closing the trade. You know, if you look at this, we are selling on this chart, but our first lot is 0.02, which is too much for us to scalp and have multiple instruments. So what we want to do now is we're going to come to manual closing, manual confirmation. We set it to true. This means that immediately this cycle of trade completed, software will now open another trade automatically, because this software is trading 24 hours. You can see starting hour is 0, ending hour is 24. So if you close any trade now, this software will open another one. So what we're going to do is to confirm manual confirmation, we set it to true, and we leave it like that. So we need to wait for this trade to complete at profit. But now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to come to PoundsUSD. The software is there, but because I have made this one on Friday, I've set the manual confirmation to true. So when it closed the trade, it didn't open another one. So what am I going to do now is that I want to put a new setting so that I will not use, I will scalp 0.01. So this setting, if you cannot do it yourself, you can call me to send you a copy of the setting, because now we want to reduce our risk. We want to reduce our risk and increase our asset we are trading. That's exactly what I want to do now. I want to reduce you can see that I'm reducing the loss size, but I'm using a martingale strategy. That's the way we hedge if you want to use this software. So yeah, we don't want to trade up to more than this. So what we are going to do here is we put 0.00. Now what we are saying here is that we are telling the software not to trade above this lot size. So now we have about let me check again, 0.03, 0.06, 1, 2, 2, 4, 4, 8, 9, 6. Then let's go up. Yeah, okay, and this is buying, so we need to save this setting. So we can see a lot of settings that I used to trade with, but don't mind yourself about this. This, what I'm showing is universal set. So now put this one is for buying, so I'll save it. Then now what am I going to do? Once I click, okay, I need to come to manual confirmation now. I'm going to set it to false, because I want it to be trading without stopping anymore. What is universal? Okay, this is it. So I need to save it again because of I change. Then I click OK. And from now, the software will start working. You see that the software, I've started placing, starts trading pounds USD, and we are buying on this. Then we go to pounds USD again. What do we do here? We are going to tell the software to be selling on this chart, because remember, we are trading edging. So one chart, the software will be buying. Another chart, the software will be selling. Instead for me to start keying something, what am I going to do is I'm going to load the previous settings that I did. I'm going to load it. But mind you, I'm going to change this point to sell, and I'm going to change magic number to anything different from the first chart. This is very important, please, guys. It's very important. So what we are going to do here, manual confirmation should be false. It must not be true. So now what I'm going to say and do now is to save this one. Then I'll call it universal sell. Universal sell. This is the way you can optimize this software yourself. Universal sell. So I'm going to save it as universal sell. Let me look at other thing. Yes, target money we want to do per trade is $1 per profit per day, per trade. Yeah, every other thing is okay. Then what am I going to do? I'm clicking OK, and maybe I click OK. This software will start selling. You see, it will start selling on this second chart. So first chart we are buying, second chart we are selling. So it will start edging the trade. So now, for us, remember that we have one open trade already, which is pounds, I mean euro JPY, and it's selling. So what we are going to do now is we are going to go to euro JPY again. We are going to do the only buying side. So we load buying, which is universal buying. Yes. I don't know why this one is always true. Let me put it false again. Okay, then let me save it. I'm going to save it as universal buy. Good. So now, what I'm going to do on Japanese yen now is I'm going to click OK. And if you look at the software, we start placing, you see, it has started placing for Japanese yen as well. But the second Japanese chart is still on selling trading. We'll leave it like that until it finish a cycle. So because if we close it now, you're gonna have problem with us. So we have our pounds and Japanese yen assets we are trading now. So we want to trade multiple assets. That's the purpose of this video. That's what I'm showing here. So we need to put the software back here on the Australian dollar. Then we want to buy. You see, to buy, you click OK here. Then we open another Australian dollar chart. We are selling on that one. So here we're going to load a sell. Good. We are selling here. So you can see that pounds buy sell. JPY buy, because we don't have sell, because we remember that this selling is still on the move. Then here I'm not going to trade pounds euro USD. I'm going to trade Japanese yen pounds Japanese yen. This pounds Japanese yen, I'm going to open it two times because I want to edge. I put the software. I'm going to load universal buy. Then I'm coming to the second one, second chart. Put the software. I'm going to load Universal Cell. Correct. So if you look at it now, we have 1, 2, which is buy sell pounds, buy sell Australian dollar, buy sell Japanese yen. Pounds, Japanese yen, but Euro Japanese yen, you only bought there because the selling aspect is still on. You see, this is the selling aspect. Once it's finished this cycle, you need to come here and close and reset it. So we started our edging with 0.01. And now we are trading 4 assets. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now that we have done that, we have chance to increase our profit and our risk to go higher. But the good thing about edging system is that it doesn't really risk. You can see everything we open now, we still have 33,000 margin level. So and equity, I mean, if you look at all this trade now, we still have 31.09 cents. Or if your account is in dollar, it will be in dollar. So this is what I just want all of us to understand about using this software. I'm going to log out from the server. So I don't need the server again. So I can come to my laptop and come and monitor the same thing on the server is what I'm going to see here. So after this, I don't need to sit on top of my computer anymore. I just need to walk away. I'll just be checking from time to time. So guys, if you can do this, please reset your account and do the same thing I showed you in the video so that you can increase your return monthly. But if you cannot do that, please just try to send me a message on the group so that I can help you set it. But I want everybody to know how this software is working and for you to be able to control it yourself. Thank you. Bye-bye for now.